When somebody comes in with a lot of bumps on their head, I know that they're afraid of having their head shaved. Shaving the scalp would probably make things easier for me to see, but I know that no one, no man, especially no woman, is going to like that. So I really like to reassure them. Okay, girls, we got a bumpy scalp ahead. And I think that they're pilar cysts, but as we know, we can't always be sure. There's a big one there that feels a little liquidy. I'm gonna try not to pop it, but you know, I don't wanna make a mess. We got our work cut out for us, because there's a few of them. So she definitely has four up there, but she's got a few other ones that, you know, it depends on what time we have or what we've got going on. Let's see if we can get, it'd be nice, because she's all the way coming from Orlando, Florida, and she's a sweetheart. So let's just get all our stuff together and get some, a lot of barrettes, and we'll be ready to go.
Okay.
Very good. Let's get started.
Dr. Lee tells me that the one on the top of my head that's open, she wanted to take it and send it in for results. That worries me a lot. I feel very nervous and anxious and, you know, it makes me scared.
Okay, I'm gonna put some numbing here.
I'm crossing my fingers and saying prayers that I have good results, that I can leave here with no bumps on my head.
Okay, here's Big Mama. Make sure nothing's ever hurting you, okay?
Okay.
I really have to approach this systematically and just make sure that each one is in good condition before I proceed to the next. It's like you're deciding whether you want to pop this balloon or not. One little cut too deep and it's gonna spill out. It's always risky removing a cyst of this size, especially on the scalp. The scalp is extremely vascular, and so if you get a little blood vessel that bleeds, sometimes it's hard to see where it's bleeding and hard to stop the bleeding. So that always complicates things and can slow you down.
Just treating it with some mad respect, let me tell you. This thing is like your old friend. Guess what? He's gone.
Really?
Big Mama's gone.
That's so awesome.
I was able to remove Rhonda's biggest cyst, but I'm not done yet because I need to cauterize the wound edges well and make sure there's no excessive bleeding. And she's still got six more cysts for me to remove, including that really unusual one, that horny one that's growing on top of her head.
I'm gonna just shift positions here. Just gonna wiggle you around, okay?
I got the big cyst out now, so that's great, but of course, a smaller one is posing a little more of a problem. Sometimes the smallest, most innocuous looking cyst can cause you the most problems.
That one made a little kissy sound.
Yay,
when it came out.
Yeah, it did. Little suction.
Yep. This one looks like it might have been a little banged up itself. It's kind of a little bit bumpy.
One of Rhonda's cysts is a little more on the bumpy side, and I think it has to do with the fact that the cyst wall on one side might be a little weaker, a little thinner. So when you blow the area up or you fill it up more, that weaker edge sort of herniates out and it creates a little knob.
I almost dropped it on her arm, her real arm. Now I think I lost a little trust in her.
The trust is still intact?
Yes, oh good.
It's such a relief to finally have an obedient cyst, and now I can finally tackle the last bump on her head. It's the one that looks like a horse's hoof. It is definitely looks different than the rest, and it might be my biggest obstacle yet.
You okay here?
Yeah.
Okay, just let me know if anything hurts. I think I numbed it up well now. It's wedged in there.
When I remove this cyst, the things that I don't want to see, which could mean something bad, if the skin was really mushy or broken down, if there's a lot of bleeding easily, if the skin looks more cancerous, it looks more injected with blood vessels and just angry and ugly. So I'm really interested in seeing what happens when I knock this horn off. All right, how am I gonna get this thing out of there, huh?
This thing's like wedged in there.
What the
heck?
Yeah, it's like it's stuck to your head. Can't be stuck to your brain because there's a skull in the way. Ay, ay, ay. Calling it a horse hoof because what the heck? This thing is rock hard. This one is like, maybe we'll just keep this one on you.
Oh, no.
No, just kidding. Are you okay?
Yes.
Okay, I almost have it off. Oh my gosh, he's almost there. You're gonna have to change your height on your driver's license now.
I know, right?
Yeah. That's a hoof. That's it.
Yay.
This surgery was certainly risky and difficult, and I was able to remove the horn completely, but I'm still not convinced that this is not a skin cancer. So I'm taking a portion of tissue and sending it for pathology to get a formal diagnosis, and I should have the results for Rhonda in a couple weeks.
Here, you stay like that, and I'm gonna give you a mirror. We put numbing and there's swelling around it. But they should flatten up. They look very bumpy right now. They're not gonna be that bumpy, okay?
Oh my goodness.
Top of your head too, that one's more bumpy. I have to pull that one tight.
Wow, that looks
see the sides
so
too.
Awesome. This looks so great.
It looks really good.
Yes, it does.
And it's not there yet either. It's just
too amazing. I was so excited that she didn't have to shave my head. So I won't have any bald spots. I'm excited about that. Oh my gosh. Oh, okay. Wow. That is so crazy. It feels so weird. The bump on the top of my head, she sent off to get tested. I hope that it comes back good, but I am still nervous about that. Dr. Lee, good. How are you? Since I've seen Dr. Lee, I'm waiting on the pathology test. I'm a little nervous.
The one that looked like a miniature horse hoof, well, that was harder for them to process. They had to really cut through it because it was like almost like cutting through a nail. I'm glad to tell you that it's nothing to worry about. It's another pilar cyst. They're all non-cancerous.
Oh, wonderful. To know and have that sense of relief that there's nothing wrong made me feel so happy.
Have a wonderful day.
You too.
Bye.
Since I've seen Dr. Lee, I've got more self-confidence. I don't worry about covering my bumps up anymore. Now I can just brush back and there's nothing there. It's just so great.